Atherosclerosis is also sometimes called arteriosclerosis. While they are not exactly the same thing, both terms are used interchangeably by many people. Atherosclerosis is only a type of arteriosclerosis. As a condition, atherosclerosis is associated with your blood vessels or arteries. It occurs when there is a stiffening or thickening of the blood vessels meant to transport nutrients and oxygen from your heart to other parts of your body. This can sometimes hamper the flow of blood to your tissues and organs.
Welcome to Simplified Health Tips, your place for factual information about achieving and maintaining optimal health. I'm Michael. Today Russell and I will be covering everything you need to know about atherosclerosis, including its causes, symptoms and treatment options. So, tap the like button, smash that subscribe button and let's go. Okay Russell, please continue with your overview of atherosclerosis. It's pretty interesting so far.
Arteries are meant to be elastic and flexible, however, certain factors can cause your arterial walls to harden, leading to hardening of the arteries and, subsequently, atherosclerosis. When fats, cholesterol and several other substances build up as plaque in and on the walls of your arteries disrupting blood flow, the condition is known as atherosclerosis. This plaque can go on to burst and cause a blood clot and is common with the heart. Nonetheless, arteries in every part of the body can be affected. Do all of these scare you? Well, the good news is, atherosclerosis can be prevented and treated.
What are the symptoms of this condition?
It is possible to have a mild form of atherosclerosis and not have any symptoms. The condition usually develops gradually and will only begin to show symptoms if the narrowing or clogging has reached a stage where it is preventing the flow of adequate blood to your tissues and organs. There are situations where the artery is completely blocked by a blood clot or a breaking apart occurs, which can cause a stroke or a heart attack. Generally, the symptoms you have would depend on which arteries in your body are affected. Let's examine a few symptoms. Atherosclerosis in the arteries leading to the brain. This is often characterized by sudden weakness or numbness in the arms or legs. You may also experience signs and symptoms such as speech difficulty or slur, drooping facial muscles, temporary blindness in one eye, and so on. These are usually a precursor to a transient ischemic attack, ITA, which can lead to a stroke if left untreated. Atherosclerosis in your heart arteries, chest pain or pressure, known as angina, is the most common symptom of this form of atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis in the arteries leading to the kidneys. Your kidney may fail if it doesn't get the required blood and oxygen to function. High blood pressure is another common symptom of kidney-related atherosclerosis. Arteries in your arms or legs. Peripheral artery disease often kicks in when atherosclerosis takes place here. Experiencing leg pain when you walk, known as claudication, is a common symptom. You should talk to your doctor if you notice any sign of atherosclerosis. Pay attention to symptoms such as chest pain, leg pain, or numbness. It is best to diagnose it and begin treatment early enough to prevent a deterioration or worsening that can lead to a stroke or a heart attack.
Sounds very dangerous. What are the causes of atherosclerosis?
The exact cause of atherosclerosis is not yet known. It can develop from as early as childhood and progress over time. Available medical knowledge has established that atherosclerosis is most likely caused by an injury or damage to the inner layer of your artery as a result of one or more of the following: high cholesterol levels in your body, high blood pressure, hypertension, high amounts of triglycerides in the body. These are a type of fatty substances or lipid in your blood. Obesity, diabetes or insulin resistance. Inflammation from diseases like arthritis, infections, lupus or other kinds of diseases. Smoking and other tobacco sources. All of these are real issues that can cause damage to your arteries and the subsequent buildup of plaque at the site of the damage or injury. When this persists, a narrowing of the arteries becomes inevitable. This leads to a blockage, preventing blood flow to organs and tissues connected to the affected arteries. Without blood, these body parts cannot function properly. Fatty deposits at the injury site may also break off eventually and enter your bloodstream. A blood clot can occur as a result, blocking the flow of blood to a specific part of your body, like your heart, leading to a heart attack. What are the risk factors for developing atherosclerosis? There are several factors that increase the risk to atherosclerosis. Aging can cause hardening of the arteries. Others include: when you have high blood pressure, obesity, where there's a history of early heart disease in your family, maintaining an unhealthy diet, lack of exercise, high cholesterol levels, smoking or using other sources of tobacco, and diabetes.
Does having atherosclerosis lead to any other diseases or conditions?
Depending on the part or organ of your body connected to the affected arteries, you may develop any of the following conditions. Coronary artery disease, where the narrowed arteries are those leading to your heart. It can cause a heart attack, heart failure, or angina, chest pain. Chronic kidney disease, when oxygenated blood cannot reach your kidneys as a result of narrowing of the arteries leading to the organ, it might be difficult to expel waste from your body, leading to severe kidney disease. Carotid artery disease, a transient ischemic attack, TIA, and stroke are the two main common complications resulting from a narrowing of the arteries leading to the brain. This easily causes prevention of the flow of blood to the brain. Aneurysms. An aneurysm simply refers to a bulge in the wall of your artery. It can occur anywhere in the body and is a serious complication caused by atherosclerosis. Aneurysms may not present any symptom. If it does lead to pain and throbbing, you will require emergency medical attention. An aneurysm may also burst and lead to fatal internal bleeding. It can be sudden and catastrophic, but may also occur as a gradual leak. Peripheral artery disease. This occurs when there is circulation problems in your legs or arms. It is caused by a narrowing of the arteries in your limbs, which may quite rarely cause tissue death. The most common symptom is reduced sensitivity to heat or cold, which can increase your risk of burns or frostbite.
How is this condition diagnosed?
A physical exam is usually the first step in diagnosing atherosclerosis. Doctors often look out for signs of enlarged, hardened, or narrowed arteries by observing for absent or weak pulse under the affected area of the artery, whooshing sound, using a stethoscope, heard just over your arteries, decreased blood pressure in the affected limb. There are several other diagnostic tests that may follow this first examination. These include blood tests. The essence of this test is to determine blood sugar and cholesterol levels and see if there has been an increase. You will be required to go up to 12 hours without anything else but water. Electrocardiogram, ECG. This records electrical signals that travel through your heart. It can reveal evidence of a previous heart attack and show signs of new ones. This is mostly specific to atherosclerosis that affects arteries leading to the heart. Cardiac catheterization and angiogram. This test is used to show blockage or narrowing in your coronary arteries. A liquid dye is injected into your arteries using a catheter, a long, thin tube. As the dye fills the arteries, they become visible on X-ray and can reveal blockage. Other tests that can be carried out to reveal atherosclerosis include Doppler ultrasound, ankle brachial index, stress test, and other imaging tests, such as CT scan and MRA.
What are the treatment options for tackling atherosclerosis?
The most appropriate treatment for atherosclerosis is usually lifestyle changes. Leading a healthy lifestyle and taking up a healthy diet are the best ways to treat the condition. However, medical and surgical procedures may be required in some cases. Medications. There are several drugs that can reverse the effects of atherosclerosis or, at least, slow it down. Some of them are antiplatelet drugs such as aspirin. This will prevent platelets clumping in narrowed arteries. Beta blocker medications, commonly used in the treatment of coronary artery disease. They reduce your risk of heart attack, reduce the demand on your heart, and relieve the symptoms of chest pain. They also lower blood pressure and heart rate. Cholesterol medications. There are two major things these medications do: lowering the low-density lipoprotein, LDL, cholesterol, otherwise known as bad cholesterol, and boosting the high-density lipoprotein, HDL, cholesterol, or good cholesterol. This can stop, slow down, or even reverse the buildup of fatty deposits in the arteries. Calcium channel blockers can be used to treat chest pain in some cases, but primarily for lowering blood pressure. Water pills, otherwise known as diuretics. They can also help to lower blood pressure. Angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors. Simply called ACE inhibitors, these drugs can lower blood pressure, help maintain the health of the heart arteries, and cut down the risk of recurring heart attacks. There are several other medications that have been proven to have some level of potency against atherosclerosis. These can be prescribed to control risk factors or treat the symptoms. Surgical procedures may also become necessary if the symptoms are severe and threaten the survival of a muscle or skin tissue. Procedures that may be recommended include angioplasty and stent replacement, and endarterectomy, fibrinolytic therapy, and bypass surgery.
What can we do to prevent developing atherosclerosis?
Just as is required in the treatment of atherosclerosis, lifestyle changes are also important to prevent it. Generally, some things you can do include: eat healthy foods, maintain a healthy weight, quitting smoking, exercise regularly, and manage stress appropriately. Atherosclerosis is a very popular disease. Coronary heart disease, one of the complications of atherosclerosis, kills more than 300,000 people in the United States annually, according to the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. In fact, the CDC reports that more than 18 million people in the U.S. aged 20 and above, almost 7% of the population, have coronary artery disease. It is important that you're very observant and see your doctor if you notice any of the signs or symptoms.
Thank you again, Russell, for helping our viewers better understand atherosclerosis. To our viewers, remember to share this video with someone who may benefit from the information. Also, leave your feedback and topic suggestions in the comment section. See you next time.